There have been many cases where rap lyrics are introduced as evidence in trials, but one of the most controversial and contested uses occurred in the case of Vontae Skinner. Skinner was a small-time drug dealer and aspiring rapper who was charged with attempted murder for the 2005 shooting outside this New Jersey house of another dealer. The case hinged primarily on two eyewitnesses whose stories changed several times. At trial, the prosecution had 13 single-spaced pages of Skinner's extremely graphic, violent rap lyrics read aloud to the jury. Here's just a taste of what they heard. Two to your helmet and four slugs drilling your cheek to blow your face off and leave your brain caved in the street. The lyrics don't mention anything about the shooting or the victims. They were, in fact, written months and years before the crime. But prosecutors introduced them to try to demonstrate Skinner's motive and intent to commit violent acts.
Getting money, homie, that ain't nothing new, though.
Amar Dean is a Philadelphia-based rap producer and Vontae Skinner's brother. He says he was in the courtroom when those lyrics were read to the jury, and just by looking at them, he says, he knew his brother would be convicted.
When they started doing the lyrics, people started frowning their faces. You know, your body language speaks volume. A lot of their faces were in shock. Whoa, did he say that? Did he do that? But it had nothing to do with the case at all.
Skinner was found guilty and sentenced to 30 years in prison. But in 2012, an appellate court ruled the lengthy reading of those lyrics unfairly prejudiced the jury, and Skinner's conviction was overturned.
Matter of State versus Vontae Skinner, may we please have appearances at counsel?
Now, the state Supreme Court will decide if Skinner should get a new trial.
The defendant's writings reference how he saw himself, either hypothetically or otherwise, reference a number of things that all go to the issue of what ultimately happened in this case.
State prosecutors testified to the court that Skinner talks about shooting people in the head in his raps, and so this was evidence of a, quote, continuing mindset that explained why he committed the actual crime. The prosecutor's office declined our request for an interview.
And political concern. Most
among those also testifying, but this time in favor of Skinner's appeal, was Ezra Rosenberg, representing the New Jersey ACLU.
When I first read Mr. Skinner's writings, they make one hold one's breath. They are extraordinarily violent. They are sexist. They are misogynistic. They're also very creative.
Rosenberg argues that, yes, Skinner's lyrics are offensive, but they're artistic works. And he says rap, like filmmaking or literature or art, should be given greater First Amendment protections before being allowed into trials. If not, he worries about a chilling effect on free expression.
Every writing is subject to First Amendment protections because there are social and political concerns that rap lyrics, gangster rap in particular, address. They are entitled to the highest protections. And that's really key to what
more
we're talking
so
about.
Than other art forms or forms of expression.
Absolutely.
Skinner's brother Amar Dean says there's another reason not to use rap lyrics as evidence, because most of the time, he says, they're fictional. Scholars of rap point out the genre comes out of a long tradition of black storytelling, one that features elaborate wordplay, boasting, and exaggeration. Dean says, just look at some of the top rap artists today. Just kill a
man. You have Ice Cube, who's a gangster rapper. He's one of the people that started gangster rap. And he's a millionaire doing movies. You have Rick Ross. Rick Ross telling about selling dope and cocaine and everything, but he was a correctional officer.
The New Jersey State Supreme Court is expected to rule on Skinner's case within the next few months.